Hello, I'm Carrie Rose. It's a pleasure to bring this flute and video concert to you. This is the third concert blending flute playing and nature that I have made during the pandemic, and the process has been a blessing. During this time, anxious thoughts sometimes consume me. My flute teacher, Joshua Smith, said that when a big orchestral solo is coming up and the anxious voices start to get distracting, you say to them, "I'm busy," and then listen to the music around you and get absorbed there. Similarly, for a time each day, I become absorbed in these projects, and this displaces anxiety. Problems emerge, but on a different scale, with interesting, manageable solutions. How will I view 32 pages of music in the woods? Oh, on a clothesline. And then what happens when the wind blows? What if the cicadas actually drown out the music? Or in the previous concert, I'm already in the bathtub with my flute and wet clothes, and I forgot to turn on the video camera. The problems are absorbing and manageable, and they quickly resolve into beauty. And the whole process puts my mind into a better space. I don't know what I would do without my art. Cicadas are present now, here, and in many of the recordings in this program. At this point in the pandemic, we are emerging like the cicadas. This program emerged with me. The first six pieces are one player, then there's a duet, and then a quintet as musicians became more comfortable being together again. Each piece is a through take like a live performance. The recordings are far from perfect, but that wasn't the point. While you're watching, you can have the best experience in full screen by pressing the square at the lower right on the video. You can set the quality on HD by pressing the settings wheel and changing the quality to 1080p HD. And I suggest headphones or good speakers. If you would like to make a donation, there's a link in the information below the video, but that is optional. Mostly, I'm really glad you're here. Both nature and music are so healing. This project is a duet between the two. It has nourished me to work on it, and I hope that it gives you some peace and joy too. And I see a little guy who wants to be a movie star. I will now play the Prelude No. 6 by Johann Sebastian Bach from his well-tempered clavier, or in this case, the good-tempered flutist. It will flow directly into a folk tune called Calliope House by Dave Richardson. This is a tune that I play for a folk dance called contradance. It's a jig, or in 6/8 time, 32 bars, and it will be repeated 3 times with variation in color and pitch. I'm here in Great Falls, Virginia at Riverbend State Park, surrounded in bluebells. The Syrinx by Claude Debussy is one of the jewels of the flute repertoire. The title evokes the Greek myth about Pan and Syrinx. Pan, a half-goat, half-man demigod, pursued the wood nymph Syrinx. She didn't return his affection, so she took flight and asked her father, the god of the river, for help. He turned her into a bed of reeds. Pan cut down these reeds and made a pan flute or a syrinx out of them. He is often pictured holding and playing upon these reeds. This was filmed at the Jug Bay Natural Area in Upper Marlboro, Maryland.
Thank you.
Philip Glass, an American-born composer, has composed operas, symphonies, music for his own ensemble, and he has collaborated with leading pop and world music artists. This has made Glass a composer who has a broad, multi-generational appeal. In Europe, he studied with Nadia Boulanger, who also taught Aaron Copland, Astor Piazzolla, and Quincy Jones, and he worked closely with the sitar player Ravi Shankar. He returned to New York in 1967 and formed the Philip Glass Ensemble, seven musicians who are amplified and their music is fed through a mixer. Glass's style is often called minimalism, but Glass prefers the description music with repetitive structures. Philip Glass wrote this duet piece in the shape of a square for two flutes in 1967. It calls for the music stands to be arranged in a square. One flutist follows their music along the outside of the square, and the other follows the music along the inside of the square. Wow, that was hard. However, for this music, for this video version, for one person in split screen, I will perform in two parallel lines where I follow the music in opposite directions. This pattern is reflected musically as well. The second flute part is the reverse of the first flute part. You will hear the musical material converge as I meet myself in the middle. The music is almost identical, and each part pulls against the other. Then the players and the music drift apart again. As Glass explained in his memoir, Words Without Music, it's as if you counted to 10 and then counted back from 10 to 1 again.
Thank you.
like this. Like this. These are two English country dance tunes from the 1600s, Lilliburlero by Henry Purcell and Maiden Lane. While I was setting up my camera in front of a field of crocuses, a man asked if I was going to interview the flowers. This recording takes place on the Long Branch Trail in Tacoma Park, Maryland. Thank you. Astor Piazzolla mixes his tango and classical training to create complex and rich realizations of tango music. At one point in his early career, after composing tangos, he decided to focus solely on classical composition and began study with the famous Nadia Boulanger, teacher of Aaron Copland and Philip Glass. He tried to hide his tango compositions from her, but when she found out about these, she congratulated him and encouraged him to pursue that path. These particular tango etudes were written for solo flute and would be too free to actually dance to, but the visceral dance elements are still present. I will play the slow and meditative etude number 4 and the energetic etude number 3.
Thank you.
Stuart Saunders Smith has been both my mentor and composition teacher. While I was writing a piece, he would ask, "What are the performers saying? What are they doing?" He has a philosophical approach. Keep listening to the music's own logic and don't push the notes around. In 2006, I commissioned this piece from Stuart for one person as an actor, flutist, and dancer. The title refers to Rose, the flower of the heart. Rose, R-O-W-S, a succession of movements, and Rose, R-O-E-S, a graceful deer. The poem that begins the piece is adapted from an Anne Sexton poem. The recording was made at Patapsco Valley State Park in Ellicott City, Maryland. The sound is the Brood 10 cicadas. I was stamped out like a Plymouth fender into this world. First came the crib, then dolls and the devotion to their plastic mouths. Then there was school, the little straight rows of chairs. Then there was life with its cruel houses and people who seldom touched. I grew like a pig in a trench coat. I grew. There were many strange apparitions, the nagging rain, the sun turning into poison, and all that saws working through my heart. I grew. I wore rubies and bought tomatoes. And now in my middle age, I am rowing. Though the oarlocks stick and grow rusty, I am rowing. This awful rowing towards God.
Thank you.
I wrote Web Passage for soprano and flute for Marta Brendan. It was commissioned by her husband, Bill Schaumann, for her 75th birthday. Marta has a big, bright smile, does much good in the world, and is an enthusiastic supporter of the arts. The piece was inspired by one of Marta's favorite poems, South Woods in October with the Spiders of Memory by Betty Adcock. Marta will recite the poem after this introduction. The piece is performed at the Patuxent Research Refuge, North Tract, in Laurel, Maryland. It was a pleasure to collaborate with soprano Ellen Kliman. You'll also hear additional collaborators, Brood 10 Cicadas.
A poem by Betty Adcock from her collection, Nettles. South Woods in October with the Spiders of Memory. There's no touch like this one, except if you remember it, your baptism. That silent passage through breaking unbreathable circles of light, where you were caught quaking in grief in the fingers of clarity. The world strung with embraces. And this air is pearled with a music far from us, but earth-struck and deep, as that water from which you could wake and wake. You can never quite see what makes it to echo and thrum with the taken. There's just this touch that is not like a lover's, is more barely moth dust and sun slant, your eyes new lashed with it. You go forward by shudder and wreckage, bearer of imperceptible message, brushing the small dead from your face. Thank you.
Sir Malcolm Arnold is an English composer who wrote three shanties in 1943. We will play the last shanty, which is based on Johnny Come Down to Hilo. Arnold is extremely playful with his rendition. The tunes go through many transformations, including frequent interruptions as one instrument starts a line and then another instrument finishes it. Featured here is the Bamboo Wind Quintet with Wes Nichols on oboe, Cheryl Hill on clarinet, Maude Fish on bassoon, and Shawn Hagen on French horn.
Thank you. Southern rendition of Chianti.
Thank you for watching this concert. Preparing this for you has given me so much joy, and I hope it passes on to you. May you be healthy and at peace.